this week, Facebook Live. We're super excited because what is this Sunday? Some may not be super stoked. I'm super stoked because I get to get my flowers, but it's Mother's Day. And what is a better way to celebrate mothers than through being here today? And I'm super excited. So we want to start with our exciting news. Starting Friday, we're going to have an awesome weekend special for Mother's Day extravaganza. So be looking in your email. You will be getting an awesome email. If you're not on our email list, you need to subscribe. Go to the site. If you stay there like for 5 seconds, you'll get this little pop-up that says subscribe now. Enter in your email so you guys can be getting those emails, and especially for this weekend because it's going to be an awesome sale. So Liv, I think today we want to be talking about mothers. But before that, we had a question come in this week on our survey that talks about how do half-tees fit over a pregnant belly? So obviously they don't fit over a pregnant belly, but they do stop right at the top of a pregnant belly, which is actually why, you know, what was it, like 8 years ago that I decided that half-tees had to be born, because I was so tired of being pregnant with this giant growing belly and trying to pull the shirts that fit me not pregnant over this giant growing belly, and it would just keep slipping up. And it would slip up, and it would slip up, and got annoying. Anyways, these are the perfect pregnant tops, okay? And they're actually fantastic for nursing, too, because of the band around the middle of them, or how they sit, they're perfect for just shelving them, nursing, and being done. And so you're not trying to take your undershirt and hold two shirts where you're trying, I mean, I'm like visualizing right now, trying to sit there and nurse a baby. You got a two-year-old crawling on your lap, so you're trying to keep them away from the baby so he doesn't, like, poke his eyes out, and then you're trying to feed the baby, all the while your other baby comes in and is like, I need some chocolate milk, and you're like, oh my gosh. Anyways, let it go. Sit down, relax, use your half tee. It props up, you're only holding one shirt, so you can let go, and you can nurse, and you can fiddle with your two-year-old and make them feel happy, and perfect addition when it comes to both pregnancy and nursing. So Mother's Day, I already told you, I'm getting flowers. It's what I get every year. It's my favorite. It's kind of my favorite little holiday because I love it when it's spring and the flowers start to come out and I get to put up my huge window boxes and they're all full and beautiful, and then I don't have to be racking my brains of what I really want, because really all I want is to be able to have flowers. So that's my gift to you from, it's been for 5 years my gift. So anyways, I want to talk about tanks really fast. I've got one on because that's going to lead into my next thing, which we're going to talk about one of my favorite half-tee stories as a mother. But tanks, they are the perfect little addition. And somebody also asked if we're going to come out with a cami tank, which would be a thinner strap here. And I would say, yes, we are. So you guys need to be paying attention because I promise they're coming this summer. So stay tuned. Anyways, fantastic. Here we go. Let's pretend we have a giant belly coming out. Again, it just shelves right on top of that. Great straps. It covers the bra strap and also helps eliminate those shirts that shift sometimes, and you still have enough coverage there that it makes it so you don't have like bra and then skin or whatever. It's a really, really nice half tee to have, and I really think you need one in every color. Obviously, of course, I would say that, but I really do think it's something you just throw on, you wear it, you don't have to think about it, and you're off to the races. Anyways, favorite half tee story. So I'm at school and I'm picking up the kiddos, and there's a little boy on the side, and his chain's fallen off. And I had just come from the gym. I don't know, it was back a long time ago. I don't even know why I was working out at 2 in the afternoon, but I was. So I had just thrown my clothes back on, and I had run to go get the kids. And I was helping this little boy. I jumped out of my car, and I was helping this, and it was a very similar shirt to this. So you can see that when I bend over, if I didn't have a half tee on, it would be kind of catastrophic a little bit, especially for like if you're a fifth grader. But so I had a shirt on like this, and I went to go help him fix his thing. And I'm leaning over, and I kind of look up at him, and I like feel like he's like so really embarrassed, right? And I'm like, why is he embarrassed? I'm just fixing his tire. Anyways, I go back down. Well, as I go back down, I kind of look down like this, and I am not kidding you. It is a good thing I had some sort of like bra on, because you could see all the way down to my feet. It was very embarrassing, like super embarrassing. And then I was like, oh my gosh, that poor kid, he's been trying to just like watch me fix his bike, but I was totally like flashing him the whole time. So that day, I just gives me that extra coverage that if I'm in those situations where I'm bending over, or I'm picking up stuff, or I'm changing, I'm fixing a chain on a tire, I can feel comfortable that I'm still covered and I'm not making anyone feel super awkward, and especially not some poor little 10-year-old just needing a nice little help with his bike. So that's one of my favorite Hafti stories. I know we've all had those moments where we're like, oopsie, what the heck am I doing? But get a tank that will take care of all those accidental moments. What else, Liv, do we want to
So why would a Hafti be the perfect Mother's Day gift?
Okay, perfect Mother's Day gift. Well, we're women. We all love comfort. We all need to fix those little problems, whether they're our arms or whether they're flashing people, that's a problem. A little extra coverage, or we like the layered look, but we don't want to be really hot. And Mother's Day, we're at the end of May, and we're starting to shift into our summer clothes, and it's starting to get really hot. So it's just the perfect addition to our closets to be able to start transitioning into those summer months so we can get those layered looks. We can, you know, we can wear the tank styles, but still have a little bit of coverage, and we don't have all the extra bulk and heat that so often we run into, especially in the summertime.
Perfect. Okay, so finally, let's just tell everyone what being a mother means to you.
Okay, what being a mother means, that's a really deep question, right?
Let's go light.
Okay, so being a mother to me, you know, we wear a lot of hats, and I just think being a mother to me is being able to simplify those hats so that we can be our best selves for our kids. And I think sometimes, too, we need to take off the guilty hat. I think moms, we carry a lot of guilt. And I think that if being a mother to me is loving those babies and seeing those babies and these kids of mine and being able to recognize their greatest potential as human beings. And if I can instill in my kids to grow up to be hardworking, contributing people into society, I think that we've done a great job. So go out there, take your guilty hat off, simplify those that you're wearing, and give your kids just the hugs and kisses, and sit down on a swing and read them a book. Or share a bowl of cereal. I mean, who doesn't love cereal?
Perfect.
Love you guys.